Hello everyone, this is lecture number 17, and from this lecture we will start unit number 2. So unit number 2, there are the sewage treatment plant. What are the stages involved in the sewage treatment plant, and each stage is having how many units, and what are the working process of each unit we will see in this particular units. So in today's lectures we will see you can see here content of a today's lecture. There will be the introduction of sewage treatment plant, then preliminary, primary, secondary and tertiary treatment plant, and what are the process flow diagram for the sewage treatment plant. So in a first content of today's lecture, that is the introduction of sewage treatment plant. First we will see sewage treatment is the process of removing contaminants from the wastewater and household sewage, both effluents and the domestics. It includes physical, chemical and the biological process to remove physical, chemical and biological contaminants. So you everyone know that, and many times I told you, the sewage is a wastewater which having the different type of contaminant or ingredient, that is in terms of physical, chemical or biological contaminant, and it should be removed before disposing into the stream or any nala. It again or further uses for the agriculture or the irrigation purpose. So though in the introductory part of the this unit, that is sewage treatment plant, why is it important? So you can go see here to removing the such type of contaminant in terms of physical, chemical and biological process. Its objective is to produce an environmentally safe food waste stream and the solid waste suitable for the disposal and the reuse. So again, the use of the for the particular water or waste water should be what? It's a first objective to produce an environmental free safe food waste stream or solid waste stream suitable for the disposal reuse. The objective of sewage treatment is to be, as you I highlighted here, so you can see here, the produce or disposal effluent without causing harm to the surrounding environment. So in surrounding environment, it should be not causing, it should be not harmfully affected. That's why the treatment are very important on the sewage. So this is the introductory part of the sewage. So what are the importance of a sewage treatment plant? You can see here, it is very important to provide some degree of treatment to wastewater before it can be used for the agriculture, landscape, irrigation, for the aquaculture. So it is very important to add some of degree of treatment. If it not some of degree of your treatment on the wastewater, and that water can be used in agriculture purpose, it may be very harmful. So that is very important to provide what to save and be used for the what landscaping or for irrigation as well as the aquatic life for the culture. That's why the wastewater treatment are be very important. So the principle of objective sewage treatment is generally to allow human effluent to be disposed of without danger to human health. So there is a principle of sewage treatment, that is what the safety or safe of a human being or human health. That's what without disposing of a water in the stream, it should be treated, and it may after treating it can be or safe or provide or prevent the danger to the human health, unacceptable damage to the natural environment as well as. So according to research, a large number of people die from the waterborne disease. Many times in the rainy seasons, the disease of viral disease can be increases in the season, and due to the only of waterborne, if the water quality has been disturbed in the season, it may be due to the wastewater or it may be due to the raining water. So that such type of if you drink such type of water, and there may be chances to increase the waterborne disease, and many of time maximum as per the research died from the waterborne diseases. So in most of developing countries, they are after very important to get the proper treatment of that water for the healthy livings. So what are the sources? Many times I told you water sources. Wastewater management sources are mainly managed by the cellular. First is the human waste. Second is the washing water. That means the rainfall collected on the roofs. And what that I'm standing. The second, third, fourth one is the domestic sources. Then the direct increase of the river water, highway drainage, industrial waste. So these are the sources which can be generated of wastewater. So wastewater treatment procedure. The sewage treatment generally involves a three stage called as primary treatment, then secondary treatment, and the third one is the tertiary treatment. This is a stage which is involved in the sewage treatment plant. Just we seen what are the importance, objective, as well as the importance of a sewage treatment plant, and what are the sources of a sewage water. Just we seen in the previous slide. Now in this slide, there are three stages in the sewage treatment plant. Sequence, that is a primary, secondary, and tertiary treatment plant. So what are the units involved in a different stage? So you can see here. So first we see here types of treatment process, particular with what the gear chamber or the particular with the characteristic, physical, chemical, and the biological characteristics. In this tabular form, you can see here, this is three number columns. And the type of treatment, physical, chemical, and biological. First, we in a physical type of treatment in the sewage treatment plant. In the next one column, that is physical types of characteristics or quality of that is a screening process and named of unit in a physical treatment. First unit will be a screen chamber, second unit will be a duty chamber, and third one is a clarifier. This is a primary treatment of any sewage treatment plant. So what are the impurities can be removed with considering or with respect to this its unit in a physical treatment? So screening, there are can be large suspended and floating matter can be removed. Then duty chamber, so only grit or sludge can be removed. And clarifier, steel, sand, and other heavier matter which can remove through these clarifiers. Now second point of treatment process, that is chemical treatment. In the type of treatment that is chemical, and there are end of chemical reactor, it can be removed or dissolved chemicals. Now next thing is that is biological treatment, that is the types of treatment that is a biological unit, and in which that there are the different types of unit you can see here again. Trickling filter, activated sludge plant, rotating biological contactor, digesters, and last one you can see is what types of material can be removed from this such type of unit. That is dissolved organic chemical, those chemical or organic matter which is dissolved in the wastewater, it can be removed through these units. So sewage treatment plant process, so you can see here the stage wise sewage treatment plant process. So this is a raw water which came from the industry or the domestic, and it firstly screen, it firstly go through this unit which is called a screening unit. Now after remaining water or clean water go through for the commuters, after commuting that water go through the clean duty chamber, and this dotted plant or colorful, you can see this is sludge or able to be settled down, it can be distributed disposal. Again remaining water goes through the primary clarifier, they will again settle down the small fine particle that is a grit or a sludge, it can be removed this direction. The remaining water is go through the secondary treatment plant. There are again some units, aeration tanks, secondary clarifiers, and in this particular aeration tank, there are provide the air compressor of the sewage in the blue directionally, and the remaining dissolved matter which can be settled down in the secondary clarifier, and the secondary clarifier again goes in this direction, and again that it aerated through the air compressor, and again came into the remaining sludge, it can be removed through the sludge treatment disposal here. So next one stage, that is the secondary effluent. After coming the water in the secondary effluent, it goes for the tertiary, and tertiary with the chlorine doses or some type of ultraviolet doses, and after that effluent can be effluent in the stream after dosing the disinfectant. Yeah, we using the disinfectant. So in tertiary treatment plant, generally the water came from the secondary treatment plant, it can be in this filter manner, and this filter has having the different types of layer, backwash tank, filter tank, treatment tank, and this particular layer you can see here, after the water came through this assembly, it can be for a disposal purpose. This is in particular backwashing, there are the air as well as air provide, and transites are different types of anthracite are provided, and air bump are provided, and particularly that water goes through this media and it again came in the clean media before the disposal purpose. So in a primary treatment plant, in primary treatment, remove the material that can be easily collected from the raw sewage before they damage or clog the pumps. And the sewage line of primary treatment clarify trash treatment and use. And I told you about these things. So in the primary treatment, remove the material, which type of material, trash tree and leaves type of leaves done. So that is floating material can be removed in the primary treatment plant. So the settle and the floating material are the removed, and the remaining liquid may be discharged up to objective of a secondary or a further process. So also from the grid chamber of the clarified, can be removed, settle or the floating material are the removed from the inner primary treatment stages. So unit in a primary treatment, you can see that was the skin bar. And the skin bar mostly used to remove the floating types of material. So that will be the can, rack, basket or factor. External types of material can be removed through the that skin bar. This is the most commonly done with an automated mechanical rack by clean bar skin in the modern plant, serving the large population wills. A somewhat less modern plant or manual clean skin may be used. So in a general, you can see the skin bar are provided with the skin chamber in any sewage treatment plant. So this is about what the grit chamber. The next one unit in the primary treatment stage, that is the grit chamber. And this is the inlet of the grit chamber and this is the outlet of the grit chamber flow. But in between that, the grit chamber, you can see the inspection port, access port, inspection port, outlet port. And this is the scum grease. And the sludge actually will settle down in the grid chamber, and one pipe which is provided, that is the outlet of a tip. So pre-treatment may be include a sand or grid channel or chamber where the velocity of the incoming sewage is adjusted to the allow the settlement of a sand. Grit stone and the broken glass, these particles are removed because they may damage pump or other equipment. So for floating metal removed by the screening, but remaining there are the sealed or any small types of metal which we are cannot be damaged pipe of a sewage treatment plant, so that grit chamber are provided. In that grit chamber, the dissolved matter or bevel silt or fine silt can be settled down in this area, which can be removed, and the further water which can be go for the further process, for the treatment process. So third one unit, that is with the primary stage, that is sedimentation tank, and this sedimentation can picture you can see here. So the water came through this inlet pipe in this sprinkle direction, and this is a settling zone of water. This is beginning through the outflow again, and in this settling zone, bottommost part, you can see this is a sludge zone. This is a mentioned sludge zone, and this is a first type of picture, that is a scraper arm. And the scraper arm, which is used to remove the sludge zone, and from that settle down sludge, which can be removed through this pipe. This is about the primary sedimentation tank or a primary clarify in the stage first, that is physical stage or a primary stage for water treatment plant. In secondary treatment plant, just to be seen one in three stage water treatment, sewage water treatment plant. And there is a secondary treatment, that is the secondary treatment remove the dissolved and the suspended biological matter. So in a particular the secondary stage, a secondary treatment just remove the dissolved and the suspended biological matter. In a secondary treatment plant, typically performed by endogenous waterborne microorganism in the managed habitat. So in the secondary treatment, there are the waterborne microorganism, bacteria, fungus or fungals are the having in that stage. It can be removed through what by some suspended biological matter. In a secondary treatment, may be required a separation process to remove the microorganism from the treated water. There are the separate process to remove the microorganism from the treated water called discharge, tertiary from the tertiary treatment. So here are the that a secondary treatment are some unit. The wastewater came from this first stage. It came from the first clarifier sedimentation tank. There is one biological unit. In that biological unit, this vertex or dotting, which is a bacteria or the rodent. And membrane or a bioreactor are the provided. that water goes through this membrane. Membrane is in the small size of skin or filter at the forehead. That water goes through this membrane. This is a membrane. And before goes through that membrane, you can see some bacteria at the forehead before entering that membrane. And turn membrane through the membrane, you can see the remaining water here. This is untreated wastewater that is permeable through the membrane, and it is a treated water. These are the secondary treatment unit, and again goes for the further treatment. So this is, you can see here, that is infiltrated water sedimentation tank secondary. Then secondary treatment, there are the different types of process. First is activated sludge process. In general, activated sludge plant encompass a variety of mechanism in the process that use dissolved oxygen to promote the growth of biological fog that substantially remove the organic material. So for removing the organic material, so biological growth, which is, that is very important, it may happen due to the presence of bacteria. It can be consumed the oxygen and it can be able to remove the organic material. So start process to tell the activated sludge process. Next process in the second treatment is a high rate treatment filter. In order to plant and those receiving variable loading, treatment filter beds are used where the settled sewage liquid is sprayed onto the surface of bed made of a cork, limestone, chips, or specially fabricated plastic media. So in the there are particular one bed, and those material which is settled down sewage, which can be sprayed on liquid on the particular media, and that media made from the coke, limestone, or chips. So due to that, biological film of bacteria is create and protozoa and the fungi form that media surface, and they eat it of the oxygens, or otherwise reduce the organic content. And this is about the treatment filter media, a rotating biological contractor. The rotating biological contractor, the effluent influent came through this direction, and this is a rotation of that liquid media, rotation of that particular contractors. It's continuously rotate, and once the wastewater goes through that rotator, it can be came through this. So you can see in the rotating biological contractor contain a number of rotating discs on a shaft submerged in the tank, partially completely filled with the liquid biofilm, go in the mobilized form of the surface of the large number of closely spaced discs, partially in the air space of the reactors. So mostly this reactor will contain number of rotating discs, which is having the shaft, and the shaft having help to the biofilm grows the mobilized form, and the large number of closely spaced discs, partially in the air space of the reactor, due to that oxygen can be mixed in the biofilm. In the tertiary treatment plant, already I told you that is a disinfectant stage. So in the water came from this direction, which is applied the ultraviolet disinfectant, and in this manners. The purpose of tertiary treatment is to provide the final treatment stage to raise the effluent quality. This is a final treatment stage to raise the effluent quality before it is discharged to the receiving environment, sea, river, lake, ground. More than one tertiary treatment process may be used at a treatment plant. So this is the last one stage of a sewage treatment plant to increase the rise of quality of what effluent before it is disposed into the discharge into sea, river, or lake. So in this stage, disinfection is practiced. So practice it always the final process. It also called the effluent policy. Filtration. Tertiary treatment process. In the tertiary process, there will be one filtration, sand filtration, removing much of residual suspended matter. Filtration over the activated carbon, also called as a carbon adsorption, removes the residual toxins. So in this manner, it can be removed through the, there are the different types of the layer, and through that layer it can be removed the carbon dioxide, as well as the filtration process. It can be a remaining sludge with that first treatment media. In the tertiary treatment plant, there are again the sludge drying beds, and that is suitable for the final disposal. When the liquid sludge is produced for the treatment, it will be required to make It is suitable for final disposal. Typically, sludge are sinked, dewatered to the reduced volume of transported off-site for the disposal. There is no process which completely eliminates the need to dispose of the biological. So here are some provided some layers of the granular types of material, small other media types of material, and that final disposal of material goes with this direction, and it will be a final disposal in the tertiary treatment plant. And so this is the last one, process in the tertiary treatment plant, that is the chlorination. The chlorination is a water treatment that destroys the viscous housing. So you know that the wastewater has a different type of bacteria, mycelium, bacteria, fungi, protozoa, and other types of organisms are present in the wastewater. And that types of bacteria, fungi, protozoa should be died through the application of the chlorine. And the chlorination also oxidizes iron, manganese, and hydrogen sulfide, so they can be filtered out. So thank you for today's lecture.